see Pia Quintana, which is a renowned chef. When did you decide that you're going to become a chef?
I know this sounds like a cliche, but since I was a little girl.
So you always knew.
I was 4 years old, and my mom tells me that I would get on the counter and just do my scrambled eggs or fix my oatmeal, and I always wanted to help in the kitchen. I would devour cookbooks when I was young. I had the pasta machine when I was 12 years old. I had an ice cream machine. I just loved it.
It was all made for to become a chef.
Well, yes. But it wasn't at a time where it was cool to be a chef.
Uh-huh.
When I told my father that I wanted to become a chef, he's like, are you kidding me? You have to have a career. Like, he didn't look at it as a career. He looked at it like
a hobby.
Yeah. I had to go to hotel management school. And after 2 years of going to university and hotel management school, I said, I quit. I want to be as excited as the architects are, as the designers are, as the lawyers, you know, they're all dressed up and they're you know, like, ready. I wanted that. I wanted to be passionate about what I was studying, and I wanted to really love what I was doing, and I hated it. So I decided finally that I was going to do culinary school no matter what.
If I say the word genius, what comes to mind first?
Genius. There's many genius, I think, in this world. I think of Salvador Dalí. I think of Calatrava, the architect. I think of Ferran Adrià, Bill Gates, you know, that have really done something to the world and have changed and have thought of outside the box.
Would you say that there's genius in cuisine?
Yes, Ferran Adrià, he's the one that did all the culinary revolution about 15 years ago. He's the one that was breaking with every single rule. I think the guy at Noma is also a genius. When they were going to give him a Michelin star, he said, well, you can give me a Michelin star, but, you know, there's going to be no tablecloths, there's going to be no fine dining scene, and he's decided to break up all the rules. Look at where he is.
Would you say that rules are made to be broken?
Of course. I'm a rule breaker. Well, I studied in Mexico City, and I started working in Mexico City for the first 2 years. And I did a stage at Barcelona, and this is when culinary revolution was going on. And for me, it was just, it opened my eyes, and I was like, I know nothing. I have no idea of what I'm doing. I need to come back. And every money, every penny I made, I changed to euros. After a year, I got an internship to go back to Spain, and I worked in a 3-Michelin-star restaurant. At that time, it was the number one in the world.
2012, you wrote a book.
Mexico Sano, yes. I think it brought me to get more of what I like to cook. I think Las Ventanas al Paraíso, it got me to get to know the product, because we had really no budget. So we got the most amazing seafood, the most amazing fish.
When you say you didn't have budget, it's like there you could just buy whatever you want.
Sometimes, you know, the fishermen didn't go out fishing. So, okay, so today we don't have tuna, but we have cabrilla. So we had to be very creative. Or the guy from the orchard, his truck didn't arrive, so there's no arugula. Okay, so we don't have arugula. What are we cooking with? Or the fisherman today decided to bring two of these and two of these, and we just had to start cooking with whatever they brought us. So the menu changed every single night.
And that's where that you brought flavor for creation.
Yes, and creativity, and I also got to know the products, because you hear about all these products, but to really try them and to really see them. And as I said, you know, I went to the orchards. There's orchards here like 25 minutes away, and we had beets in every single color you can imagine. We had eggplants. There's about 300 varieties of eggplants, and it just blows your mind to start playing with the vegetables and start playing with all this seafood. And for me, I think that's where my schooling started in learning about these products. When I got to work for the spa, they asked me to work to do the spa menu. And when I did the spa menu, the only condition was to do it Mexican. And I had to work in Mexican ingredients. And that's where I started doing investigation. I started practicing on myself, on different foods, and how I would feel. I started practicing yoga as well. And it just changed everything.
And this is where the inspiration for that book,
yes.
Mexico Sano.
Yes, because people think Mexican food is fattening and greasy, and it's not. You know, of course we have the street food, and we have healthy street food as well.
When you think Mexico, street food is just part of the culture.
Exactly, it's like Thailand. And we have a big vegetarian culture, but it's not fashionable for us. You know, it's just the... Quesadillas de huitlacoche. No, the lady doesn't put... We have vegan quesadillas. No, she has quesadillas. Mm-hmm. And it's been around forever. We have raw food that's been around forever. Our ceviches have been around forever. Right now it's something that's very fashionable. Mm-hmm. But we've cooked it for a long time, and I started to rescue all these recipes and to show everybody that there's much more to Mexican food than just
what you see.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. In 2016, you were on Top Chef.
Yes.
Which that was a great experience, and
great
probably
experience.
This is what launched you to be that renowned chef now in Mexico, wherever you go.
Well, I think it was a great experience. I think it was great exposure. It also got me more secure about myself. When they give you a challenge that's 2 minutes or a challenge that's 10 minutes and you have to really use your creativity and be very fast and very, you know, there's no mistake here. And it was good. It was good for my self-esteem. It was good for my creativity. It was a great experience. I really loved it.
Now tell me, as a chef, when you see chefs which are coming from other places, because now it's trendy to be a chef.
Yeah, now it's cool.
It's very cool. I think the biggest shows out there are about food. I mean, mm-hmm. there's so many shows on food now. But still, you still have this thing that French cuisine is better or from other countries. Like, what is your vision?
No, I'm very proud of my food. I'm very proud of being able to show what we do in my country. I love telling a story with a dish. I was just in Colombia. I was able to cook with Colombia's best chef and Argentina's best chef. But what was incredible is we did street food from our country. And I remember one of the girls, when she was trying the dish from Colombia, she's like, it reminds me of my grandmother. Mm-hmm. And I was, the dish I did, it's a very typical dish from Yucatan. It's a cochinita pibil. And it's a dish we grew up with. And you tell a story of how the Mayans came and how they used to cook it and how, you know, it's a whole technique. And just telling a story and giving you a taste of my country, you know, and for me, Mexican food can transport you to a million places, and so many varieties of chiles. We have so many varieties of spices. Corn, cacao beans, tomatoes, cactus paddle. I mean, you name it, vanilla, then mezcal, tequila. I mean, you can learn a lot about this country throughout its food. There's 3,000 years of tradition, and still techniques today we use, like the molcajete with the volcanic stone.
Yes.
We still use them today. I have my molcajete, and you know, I use it.
To do Mexican salsa, there's nothing better than that.
And when I do Indian food, I do my spices there. And you know, when I do my curries, I do them, like my molcajete is, I travel with it. I love it. It's a great tool. Mm-hmm. And it's been used forever.
Yeah.
The comales, where you heat up your tortillas. I mean, that's when I say, you know, we have techniques that have been used forever.
And that's what makes the Mexican food what it is.
Yes.
What is Pia doing when she has free time?
I do a little bit of everything.
So very active.
Yeah, I'm hyperactive.
Is it why you love this city so much?
Sí.
You are spending your time between Mexico and Los Cabos.
Mm-hmm.
You said that London is your favorite city in the world.
Yes.
You just discovered Berlin, which has this very fast pace.
Yes, I mean, I was born in a big city. I was born in the biggest city in the world. And sometimes, you know, you need that rush of the city, but Cabo gives me the balance.
Yeah, thank you so much.
You're very welcome. Thanks for coming.